I was in college, and I was taking pre-med, so that means I was taking classes in order to go to medical school to become a doctor. And so there was a mission trip that was scheduled, and I heard it was a medical mission trip to the Amazon River in Brazil. And I thought, wow, this is going to be a great experience because I'm going to get some hands-on experience to see what it's really like, you know, working with patients and doing medical procedures, and I'll really see if this is something that I want to keep studying for. And so the first thing I had to do is I had to raise a lot of money. I can't remember how much it was, but I think it was at least $1,000 because I had to pay for my airplane ticket and also the medical supplies that we would be taking. And I thought, that seems really hard. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it, but I prayed about it. I wrote some letters to people and asked some people in my church, and I raised more money than I needed to. And then I had to get a lot of shots because there's a lot of tropical diseases down there. And finally, I believe it was May 31st, we took a plane I flew from South Dakota, actually, and I went down to Miami and then from Miami to Brazil. And thankfully, I left from South Dakota because everyone else who left from Lincoln, from the college, their luggage got lost for 7 days. And we were going to the Amazon River. So it was kind of interesting that on the boat, we were on this boat on the Amazon. It was called the Luzero. Here's a picture of it. And I believe, we can ask Tarcia, but Luzero, I believe, means light bearer or something like that. And so the people who lost their luggage, they had nothing, no clothes. Can you imagine being on a boat on the Amazon River without your clothes? So the few of us who did have luggage, we actually shared our clothes with people. So some men were wearing women's clothing, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. when you're a missionary, that's the first thing, you know, plan for the unexpected, and it will happen, but you trust God and He gets you through. So anyway, here you can see I have pictures of the Luzero, and you can see here there are actually three of them that were lined up here. We had two of them that were kind of lashed together, and we actually had a 2x4 that we had to cross from one boat to the other. We slept on one side, and then the kitchen, which was in the basement, and the toilet was actually on the other side. So we had to cross a 2x4 sometimes while the boat was moving, so it was kind of scary. And at night, sometimes when the boat was docked, we could actually see eyes looking at us. And do you know what those eyes were?
Alligators.
Yeah. So we carefully crossed that 2x4. So we did everything on the boat. We slept on the boat. You can see here our hammock. Does everyone know what a hammock is? Yeah. So we slept on hammocks next to each other. And the very first night, there was actually a really big storm, kind of like, you know, the storm we had on Wednesday, where there was a lot of rain. Well, it might not have been quite that much, but our hammocks were actually moving side by side, like that, literally. And so that was another prayer. And I kind of thought of the story of the disciples when they were in the storm with Jesus and how scared they must have been, because it really was scary. And then in the morning when the sun came up and it was calm again, that peace was definitely, we loved it. So, and here's a picture of me and my friend. We all got dressed up in our Sabbath dresses and got a picture on the front of the boat. In the basement of the boat, there was also an ABC. So, actually there were books, and I can actually see those are records. You can see how old these pictures are for people to purchase to learn about Jesus. But the main reason that we were there, of course, was for medical work. On Saturday, we did do some like vacation Bible schools and branch Sabbath schools for the children. And here you can actually see this is an Adventist church, but can you see what it is? It's up on stilts, right? Because we were in the rainforest and there was a lot of rain. And I actually, on Wednesday here, I felt like I was in the rainforest too. I wish my house had been on stilts. Here is actually our toilet, but our toilet didn't have plumbing. I mean, it flushed, but that was just like with a bucket. And so all the contents actually went into the river. And we did everything in the river. You can see me here. I'm taking a bath using river water. And some people, I actually did jump in to kind of rinse off quickly, but I was scared of something in the water. What do you think it was?
Piranha.
Piranhas. Piranhas, yes. Piranha, you probably pronounced it more correctly. So they took us to more of a kind of fast flowing middle part of the river in order to try to avoid some of those things like piranhas and alligators. So some of us were daring enough to try to quickly get in. Some of the people actually swam. I would just get in quickly because I was kind of scared. And here I am with my bar soap taking a bath in the river. And then the people would like do their dishes in the river, wash their clothes in the river. I guess the waste went into the river. So the river water, of course, is not potable. We could not drink the river water. Here we are brushing our teeth on the boat. And here, this guy here, with the pink hat on, he made a chef's hat. He was called Chef Pierre. He made us delicious hot meals on the boat. I don't know how he did it, but it was really great. And here we are eating one of our meals. I remember one time a fly went into my whatever I was eating, and I just picked it out. But they actually said there was a story that if a fly or a bug goes in your food and you won't eat it again, they can tell you that you're a new missionary. And you've been there a while if you just take it out and go on eating, but you've been there too long if you see it and you just keep eating it and the fly as well. So, it was a great experience for us students because we were actually able to do hands-on things that we would never have been able to do until we were medical students or dental students here in the U.S. And we were supervised by the doctors and dentists and nurses, and they would kind of teach us things. So here we're actually observing a minor surgery. A lady had a cyst on her face. Here, one of my colleagues is learning how to triage patients, so that means that we would take like the pulse and blood pressure and determine whether the patient needed to see the doctor or what they needed. Here's my roommate actually with the stethoscope on. And can you tell what I'm doing? let's see this picture here. I'm smiling big, but you know what I just did? I pulled that guy's tooth out. So yeah, he did have anesthesia first. and here, you can't really tell this picture very well, but this was the exam room on the boat that we would use sometimes. But most of the time, we did all the medical work outside in the hot sun. And so there was one particular day. It was the end of the day, and there was a beautiful sunset. I remember thinking, oh, this really reminds me of God's love for us. We're here in this beautiful place, and we had been outside in the hot sun all day taking care of patients and getting medications for the doctors, giving shots and many different things. And we were very hot, we were very tired, and we were very thirsty. And we were going to go to a village, I think 7 or 8 miles upriver, to replenish our water. Because, of course we couldn't drink the river water, and our big water jugs, you can see here we're filling some up here, they were empty. And so we heard the boat motor splutter, and then we heard nothing. We're like, uh-oh, and they tried again, and the boat motor didn't start. And so we were getting a little concerned because we were really hot and we were really thirsty. but to no avail, and so we all prayed, and we crawled into our hammocks and we went to bed, even though we were all very thirsty. And we said, God, we need water. We need to get to the village so we can drink and continue for you. So in the morning, the beautiful sun came up, and guess what I heard? I heard a diesel engine starting. And so we were all very, very thrilled and happy about that. And we went to the village, and in the village, see us here filling up all our water bottles, and we were drinking and happy. And we saw that in the village there was an Adventist medical clinic. And so we said, oh, let's go tour that. Let's see what's inside. And there we met, there was a nurse working in there. And she said that the doctor goes to several different clinics, and he's only there once a month. And so the doctor wasn't there. And just as we were about ready to leave, a young mom, she was probably even younger than I was at the time, brought in her little baby. And her little baby had pneumonia. The baby was actually blue. We could see that her face was blue. And the nurses were saying, we don't know what to do. And our doctors, we had two doctors with us, and they actually had some oxygen with them. They had some medication for the baby, and they were able to treat the baby, and we could actually see the baby starting to, color was starting to return, and the baby was fine. And the mom was saying to us, "Oh, obrigada, obrigada," which in Portuguese means thank you, yes, you know very well. And she had tears in her eyes, and she was just so thankful. And then we realized that God stopped our boat motor for a reason, because we were there just in the at the time to save that baby. And if we had gotten there the night before, who knows what might have happened to that baby. And so we really realized that God's timing is always perfect, even if at some time we think, well, what is God doing? You know, water is good. He knows we need to drink water. But he knew exactly what would be best for us. So for our prayer, I would like to sing the song, In His Time. Do you know that song? Let's sing it. In His Time, in His Time, He makes all things beautiful. In His Time.